Hi everyone, welcome back to Online Classroom Daegu Deo. In this video, we are going to look at the last section of Chapter 5, that is the water supply system. Have you ever wondered where does the tap water in your homes come from? Well, we have a whole water supply system where the water from its origin, or maybe it's a river, maybe it's a water reservoir, all the way to your home. And I have a hard time trying to fit all of these tanks into one slide. And so I will invite you to turn to page 116 of your textbook for a clearer picture, okay? So we will look at this whole system one section by one section. Let's begin. The water will be collected from the water reservoir, or in some places they will be collected from rivers. And after the water are collected, they will be channeled into our first tank. That is the filtration tank. This first tank will function to remove only the large suspended particles such as tree branches and leaves. Those smaller ones will be taken care of in the later part of the system. After the filtration tank, the water will then pump into another tank called the oxidation tank. In this tank, oxygen will be pumped into the water to increase the oxygen content and to get rid of the unpleasant smell and taste of the water. After that, the water will then channel to the next tank called the coagulation tank. In this tank, we will add in two different things. One is the alum, and the second will be slaked lime or calcium hydroxide. What are the functions of these two materials or ingredients that we add into the water? The alum will function to make all the mud particles in the water to stick together. So all the mud that was not filtered out in the first tank, filtration tank, will then be able to stick together and form a bigger particles or a bigger balls that will become heavier and then sink to the bottom of the tank. So it acts like a super glue, okay, for the mud particles. The second thing that we add into this water will be the slaked lime, or the chemical name will be calcium hydroxide. It is a form of alkali. This is added to the water to reduce the acidity of water. After that, the water will be channel to sedimentation tank. The water will sit here for a while. So what is the function of this tank? Remember, in our coagulation tank, we add in alum, that is like super glue, okay, for the mud particles to stick together and form a bigger ones. So in sedimentation tank, these particles will deposit. They will have time to sink to the bottom of the tank, which later on we will drain out all this muddy or the suspended particles that has been deposited at the bottom of the tank. So the water up here will be clearer and cleaner. Well, the sedimentation and also the first filtration tank will not be able to get rid of everything, right? So the remaining suspended particles will be taken care of in this next tank. It is called the filtration tank. Okay, so the remaining suspended particles, especially those very fine small ones, will then be running through the filtration tank, which has sand filters. It is a giant sand filters, so the suspended particles can be filtered out. Then the water that come out from here should then be clear and clean. We have one more step though. The water will then be channeled to our last tank, not really last tank, but the last treating process, that is the chlorination and fluoridation. So in this tank, just like the name, we will add in chlorine. So if you remember from the last video when we talked about water purification method, chlorine is added to kill microorganisms, and also because of the nature or the characteristic of chlorine, the amount that we add into the water is being closely supervised so that it does not exceed the level that will affect our health. Okay, and the next substance that we add will be sodium fluoride, and sodium fluoride is added to the water so that when we use the water, it will prevent our tooth decay. So these are the reasons why from the previous video Jeku Tio say that distillation is the water that come from distillation, which is the pure water or the still water, is not suitable for drinking because it does not have sodium fluoride that we need to prevent tooth decay. After that, the water will be channeled into the clean water tank. So at this point, the water is safe for us to consume and to use, and it will then be pumped into the storage tank and then be channeled and distributed out to your homes where you will use for your daily use. Well, so that's the whole water supply system, from water reservoir or rivers into your home. The next topic that Jeku Tio wants to talk about is quite serious and it is very important. It is water sustainability. In Malaysia, rivers are the main water source. However, water pollution, just like this picture, look at that. We cannot use that water, right? So the water pollution will make water not suitable for us to consume, and it will also give a very negative impact on our environment. So let's take a look at a few water pollutants and how we can overcome water pollution. The first water pollutant is closest to us, that is domestic waste, the one that we produce from our home. So how can we overcome that? First, we should upgrade sewage systems nationwide. And also we can educate people on how we can manage our rubbish more correctly. And we can improve also the sanitation facilities, especially in rural areas. Next, water pollutants will be industrial waste, those coming out from factories. So to overcome that, we can enforce some laws to ensure that these factories will treat the waste before they discharge it into the water or the river. Okay, here are a list of laws that exist. The next water pollutant that we are going to look at will be chemicals that we use in agriculture, meaning those that come from farmers. We can educate the farmers to use biodegradable fertilizer and also pesticides instead of those chemical ones. Okay, biodegradable fertilizers and pesticides are a lot friendlier to our environment. And finally, oil spillage, especially from big boats or ships. And we can try to overcome that by surround and contain this oil at the sea using the National Oil Spill Contingency Plan revised on year 1999 and also 2000. And we can also get the help from air police units so they can patrol and watch the sea for us. Well, congratulations on finishing chapter 5. That's all from Jeku Tio in this video. I will see you in the next video, okay? Bye! If you have learned something new from this video, don't forget to like and subscribe.